One of the distinguishing characteristics of ultra successful wholesalers is their ability to find cash buyers to flip their contracts to in their prospective markets. The better you are at finding cash buyers and the bigger your cash buyer list, the easier and the faster it is to wholesale your deals and the more money you'll make per deal. In the wholesaling industry, this is often referred to as dispositions. And on today's video, I'm gonna show you my proven step-by-step process for finding a cash buyer for your deal, even if you don't currently have a single cash buyer, and how to build a massive cash buyer list. I call it my wholesaling distribution blueprint, and this is how you can 10X and scale your wholesaling business as you're doing deals every single month. All of that and more coming up.
This video is brought to you by Flipster, the nation's number one real estate software with tools for finding, funding, and flipping houses. Check it out now at getflipster.com.
If you're new here to this channel, I'm Jerry Norton with FlippingMastery.com, and this channel is all about ways to help you make money wholesaling and flipping real estate so you can live your dream life. Be sure to subscribe and turn on the bell notifications so you don't miss new videos. Recently, I did a video where I showed my step-by-step process for taking motivated seller leads all the way to signing contracts with sellers. I refer to this as my wholesaling acquisition blueprint, and it's all about having a systematic way of doing things so that you can scale, or in other words, grow into doing more deals without doing more work. It's the only way to start replacing yourself and leveraging your efforts. If you missed that video, I'll put a link in the description below for you to watch later. So this video is a continuation of that same step-by-step process in the wholesaling continuum. Once you get good at acquisitions, you need to learn how to be equally good at dispositions, or the process of moving those good deals to cash buyer investors. Wholesaling doesn't work if you acquire good deals but don't have buyers for those good deals. So on this video, I'm gonna break down what I call my wholesaling distribution blueprint. Assuming you get good at acquisitions, this blueprint will show you how to consistently find buyers for your deals so that you can do 3 deals a month, 5 deals a month, 10 deals a month, or whatever your goal is. And be sure to stick around to the end of this video because I'll show you how to get this blueprint for free. Before we get started, just a word of caution. This is something I say on my videos every time I talk about cash buyers. I believe that you focus your time, energy, and effort first on finding good deals, and then second on finding cash buyers. If that's against what you've been taught or heard from other gurus and experts, which I'm sure it is because I'm the only one I know of that says it this way, then be sure to watch a video where I explain in detail why I believe so strongly in first finding the deal and then finding the buyer for that deal. Now I'll put a link to that video in the description box below for you to watch later. What's so cool about my wholesaling distribution process is that it works if you don't have a single cash buyer or if you already have a cash buyer list. So if you're ready to roll up your sleeves, let's dig in. Right off the bat, I'm assuming you have a contract with a motivated seller, and let's say that you have a standard 30-day closing with that seller. That means you technically have 30 days to find a cash buyer and assign your contract to that cash buyer and have that cash buyer ready to purchase the property. However, even though you have 30 days, my goal is to find a cash buyer within 10 days. Honestly, if I can't find a buyer in 10 days, I probably don't have a deal. So taking a look at my blueprint, let's start with step one. Assuming you have a contract with a motivated seller, on day one, the very first thing you need to do is what's called open escrow with a wholesaler-friendly title company. Now, open escrow means that the title company is going to do a title search and prepare for a closing. This is really important to do right away in case there are issues with the property. Maybe the seller isn't the actual owner, maybe there are liens or back taxes or other issues. You want to find that out sooner than later. Now, once you open escrow, there are 3 things you need to provide the escrow agent. Your executed contract with the seller, your earnest money if you agreed to pay the seller earnest money, and what's called an affidavit of memorandum, which is a document that the title records to protect your interest in the property and prevents the seller from going around you and selling the property to someone else. Of course, I did a video explaining how this works and how to get a free copy of this document, link in the description. Now, one thing to note that is absolutely critical, that the closing company is wholesaler friendly since you're going to be assigning your contract. You want a closing agent who knows how to do that, and before you ask, I have a video explaining how to find a wholesaler-friendly title company, link in the description. Step two, which should happen by day two in the timeline, is to create your property profile for marketing your deal to cash buyers. I believe in being a full service wholesaler, which means the more information you can provide a cash buyer about the merits of your deal, the easier it is for them to make a decision to buy your deal. So what things should you include? The address, detailed pictures, after repair value, repair breakdown, list of relevant comps, features and benefits about the deal, your price, and the date and time for your inspection open house, which I'll cover on step four, so keep watching. And if you really want to separate yourself from the other wholesalers in your market, there are additional services you could provide your cash buyers. And I did a video where I explain in detail, link in the description. If you have a wholesaler website, you can create a deal gallery with all of this information and then have a link to provide your prospective cash buyers. And you guessed it, I have a video explaining the very best way to showcase your deals with a website. Link in the description. Now, once you've gathered and created your marketing material, it's time for step three, which is to find a cash buyer for your deal. Now, this is the most important step of all and where I'm going to spend the majority of the focus on this video. There are three different ways to find a cash buyer while building a buyer list at the same time. Remember, we find a cash buyer after we have a deal and we build our cash buyer list as we go. So let's start with no cash buyer list. Maybe you're in a market where you've never done a deal before, which happens to me all the time. Or maybe your buyer list is really small and none of those buyers are interested in your deal. Or maybe you're brand new and you don't have a single buyer on your list. At any rate, you have a deal and desperately need a buyer ASAP. What do you do? Well, think about it. The ideal cash buyer for your deal would be a cash buyer who is actively doing deals in that same neighborhood where your deal is. Why? Because all investors like to do repeat deals in neighborhoods where they currently or previously have done deals. So let me show you three different ways to find cash buyer investors in the same neighborhood as your deal. And I'm going to show you how to find them for free using Zillow, Redfin, Realtor.com, Trulia, or any other public site. Now, the first would be a cash buyer who recently bought an on-market distressed property for cash and is currently in the process of fixing it up. They would be ideal because they might be thinking about their next deal and be interested in your deal. Now, these are easy to find. Do a search on Zillow for the lowest price sold transactions in the past year in the same area as your deal. Now, these are more than likely cash buyer investors. The second would be a cash buyer who bought a distressed property and finished fixing it up, and now it's currently listed for sale. They would be ideal because now it's completed, and while they're waiting to sell it, they might be ready to start a new project. These are also easy to find. Do a search on Zillow for the highest price homes for sale in the same area as your deal and look to see if they are newly renovated, vacant, and possibly staged. That lets you know it was a flipper who might be interested in your deal. And the third way would be a cash buyer who bought a distressed property, fixed it up, listed it for sale, and sold it. In other words, a completed fix and flip. They also might be looking for a new deal. On Zillow, search for the highest priced sold homes during the past year in the same area as your deal, and also look to see if they are newly renovated, vacant, and possibly staged. Again, that lets you know it was a flipper. So to recap, a local active investor in the same neighborhood who bought a distressed property and is either currently fixing it up, actively selling it, or already sold and flipped it. Now in a minute, I'll show you how to contact these cash buyers directly, but if you're in a hurry, simply call the agent that represented the investor and ask them to tell their cash buyer about your deal. They will be motivated to help you because that's another property for them to sell and earn a commission. Here's what you would say. Hi, Mr. Agent. I'm a local investor and I noticed you represented a flipper on 123 Main Street. I'm calling you because I have a deal in that same area I'm looking to sell and I think your investor may be interested. Can you contact him to find out if he's looking for another deal in that area? Now, to help you see this in action, I did a video where I actually get on the phone and you get to watch me look up, find, and actually call agents. Now, this video will really help you see this technique in action. Link in the description. The process of finding these active investors and contacting the agents should only take a few days, so let's do that on days 3 through 5 on our timeline. And like I said, I've never not found a buyer doing this. As long as you actually have a deal, it works. Okay, now let's walk through the steps if you do have an existing cash buyer list. I like to segment or profile my buyers list into 3 categories. Category 1 is what I call my A-list buyers. These are cash buyers who make a decision fast. often without even seeing the property. They have their funding in place and they make a decision instantly. They are your best buyers and are worthy of a personal call from you. When on the phone, tell them that you are giving them first shot at the deal and you're going to give them a day to decide before you let the rest of your list know about the deal. You want them to feel like they're getting VIP treatment, and they are. Of course, you call the next A-list buyer and tell him or her that you're giving them the first shot at the deal too. So day three, call your A-list. If they don't take the deal, on day four, you contact your B-list about your deal. Your B-list are good buyers, but they require hand-holding. They need to see the property, get approved for funding, maybe get bids from contractors. They have lots of questions, etc. They're still good buyers, they just take more work. Your B-list buyers get a text and an email about the deal on day four. Then on day five, you blast the deal out to your C-list, which is everyone else that is not on your A or B-list. These are people that you just have no knowledge of who they are and what their buy criteria is. They just somehow made it onto your list. Now, the third way to find a cash buyer is more of an ongoing strategy to build a massive cash buyer list following a similar method as we do to find motivated sellers. That is, you can acquire a list of cash transactions in your market from a list provider. Once you have a list of names and addresses, you can skip trace the list to get phone numbers. And once you have phone numbers, you can cold call, text, or send a ringless voicemail, and you can do this in bulk. For example, you could purchase a list of 1,000 cash buyers, skip trace the entire list of 1,000, and then send a text blast or RVM blast to the entire list of 1,000. If you hustled, you could do that on days 3 through 5 and find a buyer for your deal, and you could also do this on an ongoing basis. This is one way that the pros continually build bigger and bigger cash buyer lists. Now, before we move to the next step, I want to let you know that I've created word-for-word scripts for exactly what to say to cash buyers in these different situations when you call them, as well as scripts for texting and leaving messages, even email scripts. Now, if you'd like these scripts for free, I'll put a free download link in the description box below for you. Whichever method you use, once you have interested cash buyers, most of the time they are going to need access to the property. This takes us to step 4, which happens on day 7. I call this an inspection open house. It's a 2-hour window where all of your interested buyers can do an open house and visit the property. Make sure to tell all interested parties that this is the only time to see the property and to bring their partners, contractors, etc., because there won't be another opportunity to see the property. Now, I do it this way for 2 reasons. First of all, it's a logistical nightmare trying to schedule separate individual appointments for every interested buyer. But the main reason is to create an auction environment. You want them all there at the same time to create a sense of urgency. Even though you've given your asking price, you instruct all interested buyers to submit their highest and best offer to you by the following day at 2 p.m. Then step 5, which happens on day 8, is to accept the best offer and execute an assignment contract, and then get that contract along with the cash buyer's non-refundable earnest money to the same escrow agent who you opened escrow with on day 1. If they are wholesaler friendly, they will know exactly what to do. Now, like I said earlier, my goal is to secure my cash buyer in 10 days, so this gives me a day or two extra. Then step 6 happens on day 30, or whenever the closing is scheduled according to your contract with the seller. On the day of closing, the cash buyer closes directly with the seller, and if the title agent knows what she's doing, you don't need to attend the closing, and the title company will wire you your wholesale proceeds, and you, my friend, just followed my 6-step wholesaling distribution process and flipped your contract to a cash buyer. Now, I did want to let you know there is one more option to wholesale your deal, and that's to me. I buy, fix, and flip deals anywhere in the US, and I'm always looking for good deals. If being a finder for me sounds interesting to you, then be sure to register for a free online training where I go over all of the details. Just go to my10kcheck.com. Okay, like I said, to get my wholesaling distribution blueprint, all of my cash buyer scripts for free, be sure to click the link in the description. All I ask is that you leave a comment and say, "Thank you, Jerry, you are a flipping genius." And if you haven't yet, be sure to subscribe to my channel with hundreds of videos and new videos released every single week. This is the #1 channel on YouTube for all things wholesaling and flipping. And remember, it's not about the money, it's about having the time and freedom to have, be, do, and give everything God has in store for you. That's what it's all about, and I'll see you on the next video.